teach them well and let them lead the way. Show them all the beauty they possess inside. Give them a sense of mind to make it easier. Let the children's laughter remind us how we used to be. Everybody's searching for a hero. People need someone to look up to. I never found anyone to fulfill my need. A lonely place to be. So I learned signing long ago, never to work in anyone's shadow. If I fail, if I succeed, at least I live as I believe. No matter what they take from me, they can't take away my dignity. Because the inside and give them a sense of pride. Easier if the children's laughter remind us how we used to be. This time long ago, never to walk in anyone's shadow. If I pray, if I succeed, I live as I believe. No matter what they take from me, they can't take away my dignity. Because the
perfect, 10:02. Hi, everybody. Nice to see your faces. And here's Reverend Sandy to start the service.
Absolutely. And Good morning, everyone, and welcome to Unity of Michiana Spiritual Center. And welcome to those of you who are joining us via our live stream service. It's always wonderful to have you participate and join with us because we can feel that energy across the miles. We touch heart to heart, and it's great to have you all here. This is a special Sunday. It is the Sunday where our youth are doing our service today, and that's always exciting and wonderful experience where they come together and creatively and to present the Sunday message for the day. And it's also a special day because this year we have one of our YOUers who is graduating, Catherine McLaughlin, and so there will be a wonderful ceremony to honor her. So thank you for joining us. It is great to have you be here. And here at Unity of Michiana, we are a heart-centered, multi-generational, and a diverse spiritual community. We're dedicated to teaching and practicing a positive life approach in our spiritual journey. And our vision is a world that is united in loving acceptance, celebrating inclusivity, harmony, prosperity, and awakened consciousness. And so I'll ask Patty to light our Christ candle. And so let me open in prayer as we all together breathe into this moment. And as we do so, we just kind of let the past week fall away or the week to come. And with each breath that we take, we center into the heart of our being, into that which is our own innate divine self. And in this place of the breath, as we celebrate and acknowledge the inflow and the outflow of universal divine spirit, we are receptive to this very special day, to this celebration and this experience. And we are grateful for the insight, for the upliftment, for the connection that we feel as we gather together. We pray this in the light, in the love of the breath of Yahweh, beloved Mother, Father, God, and so it is. Amen. And now, Catherine, I'll have you come forward to bless our youth and call them forward. We see you surrounded in the light of God.
And we hold you close in our hearts.
And we hold you close in our hearts. Cameron's coming on up here, huh? And I'll turn it over to you, John.
I picked these songs with the idea of the children, you know, being in a children's service. I think it's what popped into my head. So anyway, please sing along. Where are we here? I see divinity in you. I see the Christ coming through in all of your passions and all thing of love. In all of the glory that you are made of, now and forever on earth and above, I see divinity in you. I see the wonder you are, and in your light through the dark. Exploring the vision that you've obtained, let none of the treasure go slipping away. Here and hereafter, the love you can say, I see divinity in you. I
see divinity in you.
A little mistake there. Sorry about that. This one might not be easy to sing, but it's a beautiful song, and just do your best.
You will do amazing things with each new day bring. So with every step you take, blessed progress that you make. The reason you live is there in every gift you give. Love your life, love your dream. You will do amazing things. Just enjoy what this day brings. You will do amazing things. Amazing, amazing. You will do amazing things. Singing.
In Unity, we have a wonderful booklet. It's called Daily Word. It has a wonderful prayerful message for us each day of the year. And Alina will come forward to read our Daily Word for us today. She'll be reading Saturday's Daily Word.
Our daily word for today is willing. With an eager heart, I am willing to go. My spiritual growth is ongoing, even when I think I finally arrived. When God feels close and I have a solid understanding of the word in my place, and it, that feeling will be only temporary. Soon I will feel a nudge to go deeper, learn more, and grow even closer to God. Through it all, I remain willing to answer the call of my soul, even during moments of disconnect. I realize I am being called to grow. I am grateful for how I've grown. I am also grateful to know I will never finish growing, that there are always going to be opportunities to know God is new, exciting ways. The top of any mountain is the bottom of next one. I pause in gratitude for how far I've come and renew my willings to keep going. Restore to me the joy of your salvation and sustain in me willing spirit. Psalm 51:12, our daily word for today as well.
Now I invite you to just join with me in moving into a time of mindfulness, time of prayer, meditation. As we just take this time apart from the busyness of our outer world in order to center into infinite spirit, to be uplifted and renewed, to reconnect, to remember. So I invite you to breathe, to relax, to let go, and as I do so, I will tone our singing bowl and let that musical resonance, that musical note that is resonant to the heart chakra of love, let it move through your being to open all of your channels, all of your experience, all of who you are. And so as we come into this moment in that place of being willing, as our daily word shared today, being willing to be open to infinite spirit, open to seeing differently, to growing, to embracing life in ways that move us forward into a greater understanding. Greater understanding of our purpose, of who we are, of the gifts that we have to share, of the light that we shine forth, of the love through which we connect with each other. And so we breathe and we exhale and release any tension or anything that we are still carrying with us from the past week or considerations of the week to come, and we allow each breath in this moment to bring us present. Into a recognition of the wholeness, the allness of who we are in our connection to the flow of the breath of life, of divine pure being. In expression through us and as us. And so in this moment, we let that light heal us from the without to the within, and from the within to the without, like the breath moving in and out and in and out, like the tide, like the natural flow of all creation. And we give thanks as we connect to the infinite spirit ever present that connects us into one whole and complete tapestry, blended with each other, with our own unique talents, embracing the gifts that we give, receiving the gifts that are shared, And on this day, as we celebrate our youth, as we are grateful for the light that they share with us, we allow it to warm our hearts, our very being. And as we see the light within them, as we see the gifts that they share, it reminds us of a greater truth of ourselves. And for this connection and for these gifts that we receive, we are so grateful. So we just take a moment in silence to let our light shine forth and also to receive the gifts of spirit in this moment of connection with all being in the silence. And from this place of being nurtured and infilled, from this place of recognizing the light of who we are and shining that forth, in this now moment, we surround our prayer box in light and all the prayer requests that have been made. And we take a moment to speak aloud the names of loved ones, places, situations that we would especially bless at this time. Karen, Shireen, Donalyn, Sue Ellen, Terry, Matt, Courtney, Unity of Michiana, Unity Worldwide Ministries and World Headquarters, Tamara, Chrissy, Tim, Sue Ellen. Colleen. Jolene, Richard, Sue Ann. And so we breathe light into these intentional prayers spoken out into the universe, carrying that positive energy of upliftment, healing, and love. And so we pray this forward in and through the grace of divine spirit. And so it is. Amen.
Breathe through me, breathe through me. O blessed Spirit, breathe through me, breathe through me, breathe through me. O blessed Spirit, breathe through me. Live through me, live through me. O blessed Spirit, live through me, live through me, live through me. O blessed Spirit, live through me. Just imagine it, just imagine it, just imagine how it could be.
I can see myself as I want to be and be the way I want to be. Just imagining, just imagining, just imagine how it could be. I can see myself as I want to be and be the way I want to be and be the way I want to be.
Good morning and welcome to our youth service. We want to start by thanking our congregation, especially our board members, for the pod outside that will soon be used for the youth to meet in. It means so much to finally have a space of our own. To thank them, we will be giving them the full unity blessing. I ask the youth to rub your hands together. We bless you, we appreciate you, and we truly behold the Christ in you. Namaste. Now, it's not a youth service without a silly
joy song.
I'm going to be leading Tiny Turtle. We're going to be going to
slow is just too fast.
I had a tiny turtle, his name was Tiny Tim. I put him in the bathtub to see if he could swim. He drank up all the water, he ate up all the soap, and now he's in the bathtub with the bubble in his throat, singing bubble, 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 pop. I had a tiny turtle, his name was Tiny Tim. I put him in the bathtub to see if he could swim. He drank up all the water, he ate up all the soap, and now he's in the bathtub with the bubble in his throat, singing bubble, 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 pop.
I had a tiny turtle, his name was Tiny Tim. I put him in the bathtub to see if he could swim. He drank up all the water, he ate up all the soap, and now he's in the bathtub with the bubble in his throat, singing bubble, 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 pop.
Okay, we do these youth services to let kids come up with a story and get their chance to act it out and show off their talents or what they're proud of. Whether it's their singing or gymnastics, kids get to incorporate their skills into their own story. We also use the story to convey some sort of message they have learned during this year. Our skit today is about the power of prayer and meditation. It begins with two sisters, Emily and Autumn, going for a walk in the woods.
Wow, Autumn, look at that tree over there. It's beautiful with flowers all over it.
Wow, that tree is beautiful. The flowers look like they're magical. Wow, look at that mushroom, Autumn. Emily, it's so big.
I love it. It's beautiful. Wait, Autumn, are we lost?
No, let's go this way.
You know, when we go on vacation, it's going to be so much fun. We're going to go to the beach and everything.
I know. The first thing I'm probably going to do is swim.
Yeah, we're probably going to make sandcastles and everything like that.
Mm-hmm. I'm excited.
Save yourself. We are lost, aren't we, Autumn?
No, let's just go this way.
We're going to probably, find seashells and everything like that.
Yeah, we can put them on the sandcastles.
That'd be so much fun. We can build, a little door for ants.
Or something.
We are lost! We are lost!
What are we going to do?
I don't know. What if it storms?
I need my dad.
I need food.
I'm cold.
I'm getting so sleepy.
What are we going to do if an animal comes?
I don't know.
We need to pray.
And meditate.
Our thoughts are prayers, and we are always praying. Our thoughts are prayers, and we are always praying. A higher consciousness, a state of peacefulness, and know that God is always there. And every thought becomes our prayer. Our thoughts are prayers, and we are always praying. Our thoughts are prayers. Be careful what you're saying. Seek a higher consciousness, a state of peacefulness, and know that God is always there. And every thought becomes our prayer.
You got this. You can find your way home. You were safe. You were smart enough.
Hey, Emily, there's that mushroom we saw earlier.
Hey, and Autumn, there's that tree we saw. This is the right way home!
Emily and Autumn find their way home, safe and sound, because they remembered to center themselves with prayer and meditation.
Gives me the greatest pleasure and privilege as well to celebrate our YOU graduate. I've known her for, somebody said 11 years, I think it might be longer, but I don't know. It's been a long time, and the way she has developed into this amazing young woman is amazing. Anyway, she did go through the bridge and on YOU, and now she's graduating from YOU as also. And now we have a little video to share.
We're working on it.
Okay.
For one of our plays, and I cannot believe that you are graduating. It's unbelievable to me how quickly time flies. I remember when we were sat on the ladder for one of our plays and how comfortable you were. You're really a talented young woman, and I have loved knowing you, and maybe we'll see each other soon. Love you.
That was our Nani. Some of you may not even know her, but she was our YOU, what's the word for it? Sponsor. She was the YOU sponsor for many, 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 many years, and she's retired, but she wanted to deliver that message to Catherine. Obviously, a heartthrob message, but anyway. Well, we now begin the rest of our service, but before we do, I just want to give thanks to Catherine, because she did an amazing job helping us out with the youth this year. She is so understanding, kind, caring, thoughtful, and a blessing. So thank you, Catherine. Now Catherine wants to
Wow, I did not know Donalyn sent something. Of course, you do that right before I give a speech.
Take a really deep breath.
Oh, man. All right. Whew. For those who don't know, my name is Catherine McLaughlin. I go by Cat to pretty much everyone but my mom, so a lot of you probably know me as Catherine, but I do go by Cat. So I'm Cat McLaughlin, and I've been a member of Unity for almost as long as I can remember. I remember church hopping for a few years, but most of my memory is being a part of Unity. Growing up a part of Unity has been a major blessing for me. From a young age, I was surrounded by people who embraced diversity, practiced unconditional love, encouraged me to go on a powerful spiritual journey. The teachings and values of Unity have been a guiding light throughout my life, even when I was too young to really comprehend just how lucky I was to be here. When asked to reflect back on my time here for this speech, I couldn't help but just be filled with that overwhelming sense of gratitude. This community has played such a pivotal role in shaping who I am today. For example, and for those who don't know, I totally lost my spot. Give me a second. For those who don't know, I am lesbian, and admitting that and using that label initially was very difficult for me. But when I came out, I was instead given a safe, supportive, and understanding environment here at Unity. And that's something I will forever be thankful for. Unity is also where I got some of my first chances to perform skits, like the one of me on a ladder that Donalyn talked about, one of my favorites. And I got to do speeches in front of people, and that's one of the things that found my love for being on stage and performing. And since I've graduated high school, I now plan on doing theater for the rest of my life. It's my passion, and it's something Unity helped me find. This is such a supportive community and a loving community, and it's helped me find my passion. The spiritual practices I have learned here, like meditation, affirmative prayer, and conscious living, have given me a guide to better navigate life's many ups and downs, with even more understanding. This year particularly, with all its chaos, like graduating high school and dealing with so much friendship drama, it's just really helped me gain a deeper understanding of my emotions and that divine connection within me. I'm so thankful to Reverend Sandy, my mom, Patty, Natalie, and so many others, and all the dedicated volunteers who have poured their hearts and time into making this a place, a warm and inclusive space for everyone. All of your commitment is truly inspiring and appreciated greatly. I'm blessed to call Unity my spiritual home. And to everyone here, may the light that shines within each of us continue to illuminate all of our paths forward. Thank you.
Better this way.
Baby girl, you're such a beautiful soul, and I'm so proud to be your mom. Monday, when she graduated from Penn, she was all decked out. She earned the white stole
for earning a diploma with high honors by being in and doing well in so many
advanced placement classes. She also earned 3 chords and a medal. 1 chord for taking 4 years of German and one for being on the academic Super Bowl team. You are so smart and such a hard worker. That will serve you well in everything you do. And she is quite the artist. Mm-hmm. The other chord is for 4 years of orchestra, and the medal is for being in at least 4 theater productions. She does digital art, plays the violin,
and is an actress and a writer too.
You are so talented. Oops, just hit that. All right, you're so talented. I pray that you will continue to share your talents with the world. In addition to all the things that you can see, you are also passionate, strong-willed, brave, courteous, kind, and joyful. When we named you Catherine Joy, I had no idea how much joy you would bring into the world just by being you. When I was preparing for this graduation ceremony, I was told that this runner was for graduation, but no one quite remembered how Donalyn used it. So that was kind of exciting for me because I got to decide how I was going to use it. So I realized that during our fly-up, the youth cross a bridge as they enter YOU. So we're going to use this runner as a bridge, exiting out of YOU. Catherine, as you leave the sanctuary today, you will be leaving your role as a youth within our congregation and stepping into your role as an adult. Dad made this beautiful vase for you yesterday. It has the I am on it and each one of our 12 powers. Our runner also has the 12 powers on it. When life gets tough, which it will, I hope that this will serve as a reminder of who you are. All right, is everyone ready? All right, Catherine, please come on down and stand on the first power. Okay, when you stand on a power, I would like you to claim it as your own. I am faith.
I am faith.
Nope.
You are.
This is a song for Catherine from all of us.
Sing. And may sunshine and happiness surround you when you fall from home. And may you grow to be proud, dignified, and true. Do unto others as you'd have done to you. And be courageous and be brave. And in my heart you'll always stay forever young. Forever young. Forever young. It's hard to sing when you're crying. Sorry about that.
And so I would like to just take a moment, Catherine, and the light that you are. And since you were a little tyke and you came and you were so creative and you were so out there and willing to be who you were, even though it was a little scary at times. And even though you were finding your way, you stood with that conviction of who you are and who you were becoming. Because you showed up in your desire for your spiritual growth and how you shared that also with the rest of the youth as you took on positions of leadership in teaching and being with them. And as you step forward to light our Christ candle and bless our youth, it has been a precious blessing to me to watch your growth through the years and to see that light as you graduated on Monday. Oh my gosh, friends, all day long she just glowed. And now also, and know that as you stepped off that runner into life, you are now moving into that next chapter, and we are so grateful that you will be a part of us in a different way and in a different expression. So we're looking forward to getting to know you differently. We look forward to the light that you share out in our world. Many blessings to you with so much love in my heart. Yes. And so now as we conclude our service, I just like to go over a few of our announcements because we have some wonderful things coming up. Just want to remind everyone, we do have our delightful Zoom class or Zoom gathering that we meet by Zoom every Wednesday for about an hour from 6 to 7, 7:15. And we discuss a book we're working with, Discover Your Divinity, right now. And then we have a time of prayer and meditation following that. We also share prayers with each other. It's a wonderful time together in the middle of the week. So would love to have you join us. You click on the Zoom link and you join in and we can see each other. It's a wonderful time. So please join us on any Wednesday evening to be a part of that. Also, I'm excited to once again do a talk series called You Asked For It. I've done this in the past through the summer. And if you have a question about unity teachings, about metaphysics, or applying truth principles, or anything that is going on in your life, we will have sheets out for you to write those questions. And as I'm able through the different Sunday services, I'll be talking about the questions that you asked, and we'll be taking a look at and exploring truth principles. So we've done really well in the past with this, and so I look forward to it. I always enjoy doing this particular series of You Asked For It. So be sure and put down the things that you have questions about. Those are greatly appreciated. our monthly Mexican train dominoes group that gathers together and plays after the service. Normally meets on the third Sunday, but that's going to be Father's Day. That's next Sunday, and that will be Father's Day. So they are moving it to Sunday, June 23rd after fellowship. So this 1 month, it'll be a Sunday later. And last, I don't know if you'd care to come forward. Come on up here. You can. So next Saturday, we will be participating for this. Well, actually, we've participated in other years, but we had a wonderful booth that was headed up by Sue DeRoos and Cecilia McBride. And so I will let you talk about that for next Saturday.
We're looking for people to come, sit in the booth, and help out. We're going to be handing out pinwheels and pens and brochures and all kinds of Unity things. And it would just be great if we've got some volunteers now, but the more the merrier. So just let me know when you can come, and it'll be a great time.
Thank you. They set up such a wonderful booth last year. I know Tim and Alex helped with a lot of that, and Chrissy did. So many people were a part of setting that all up, and so we had a great presence there, and it was just a delight, and a lot of people stopped in to talk and pick up the brochures, and it's just a wonderful event overall. The whole park has different kinds of representatives there, and crafts, and food, and all kinds of things. So if you can either come and sit in the booth for a while, or if you just want to come and experience it, it's a wonderful thing to do next Saturday from, is it 1 to 7?
No, it's 11 to 7.
Oh, it's 11 to 7. Thank you. I don't know where I thought. Oh, there we go. Okay. Sue and Cecilia and all the volunteers are going to be there at 11. And so come on down, get there early, kind of get the lay of the land, and then start wandering around at one. So thanks, Susan, for that clarification. So that concludes our announcements for today. And at this time, let us focus our intention on our contribution and our love offerings in a recognition that this is a spiritual community made up by each and every one of you. And so it is your contributions solely that support Unity of Michiana. And we are grateful for those love offerings in a recognition that we are all a part of the infinite flow of divine prosperity, and that God, the source of life, is truly our source of prosperity, and we just call that forth, and then we share it, and then it comes back to us overflowing. And so in whatever way you choose to give, you can go at our Unity of Michiana website, our Unity of Michiana phone app if you care to. We have a QR code, we have a contribution basket in the back. However you care to contribute, you can set up a one-time donation or an ongoing donation for when you're not here. We receive these gifts in that consciousness that it is truly the flow of God, and we are grateful. So if you will hold that gift in whatever form you are giving it, figuratively or in your hand, and affirm with me our love offering affirmation. I am a joyful recipient of God's bountiful blessings, and with a grateful heart, I give freely in return. And so as we bless these gifts, we truly give thanks. And honoring that abundant flow of divine pure being, supporting us in all ways, financially, spiritually. And for that, we are so very grateful. Thank you, God. Amen. And so before we close, I'm going to have you all stand, but I'm going to have Martha and Patty come forward first, please. And also Brandy, please come forward. Right here, front and center.
Go, Mama.
come on in. So as we take a moment to be grateful for the presence of these three beautiful women, their spirit shines forth, their love for our youth, for how they contribute, for how they show up week in and week out, and how they are willing to not only share their life learning, but also to receive and learn from our youth all the gifts that they have to give. We especially give thanks to Martha, who is our youth coordinator, and who, along with Patty and many others, created the wonderful service today, but ongoing carries that role of leadership to keep our youth on track and going forward and attending the youth rallies and just this wonderful, wonderful expression of light and of love.
And I have a small token of our appreciation. Because Martha was amazing.
Yes.
Thank you so much, Martha.
So we can all clap and give her thanks. And I just wanted to say personally to all three of you, how deeply you touch me and your willingness to be present. Most of you know that I started in Unity when I was like 8 or 9 years old. And that was a long time ago. and how much, as Catherine shared, that it has molded her life, and it certainly did mine. And so the fact that you carry the torch to continue that forward in this day and age when things are a lot different than when I was 8 or 9 years old and when we had the classes at Unity and the things that I participated in. And I see each of your hearts sharing, and it touches me deeply. I am very grateful. I love all three of you. Thanks for all you do. Let's give them a second big round of applause. Okay, and you can stay up here. We're all going to sing Peace on Earth, so you can stand and we'll sing Peace on Earth together. And all the youth, come forward and stand up here if you would.
Sky above, the mother earth beneath. Peace on earth, peace on earth, peace on earth, peace on earth. Sisters and brothers all the world around, lift our voices high.
Before we close with our prayer for protection, let us rub our hands together and bless our youth and our youth teachers. What we will say is, we love you, we bless you, and we truly appreciate you. We behold the light of Christ in you. Okay. We love you, we bless you, we appreciate you, and we behold the light of Christ in you. And thank you so much. Let's give them another round of applause. And we will close with our prayer of protection. The light of God surrounds us. The love of God enfolds us. The power of God protects us. The presence of God watches over us. Wherever we are, God is, and all is well. And
yay,
God! There we go.
Then may sunshine and happiness surround you when you're far from home. Then may you grow to be proud and dignified and true. And do unto others as you'd have done to you. And be courageous and be brave. And in my heart you'll always stay forever young. Forever young.